Gaffney leading in the center of the field. First of all, for Sumter, number 55. Elliot Major, number 63, Steve Duggan. Second for Gaffney, number 73, Mark Chandler, and number 22, Michael Bridges.
Thank you.
Service made by Bubba Smith. two, John Dewey. 48-yard line, line of scrimmage.
Pass.
good.
Here we go.
SCAA Division II quarterfinal score. Herman Paladin, 59. Rhode Island, 15. Sumter. Thank you. Field. each player will please take his position. We'll begin our championship ceremony. First with the presentation of the medallions, if you line up along the 45, each team and coaching staff. Each player representing the lower state championship, Sumter High School. Being the principal of Sumter High School, Rick Starr. Superintendent of Sumter School District number 17, Dr. Lawrence Clifford. Laura Ayers, board chairman. In order and numerically, medallions will be presented to, first of all, for Sumter, number one, Stacy Robinson. Number two, Alfred Johnson. Number three, Odell Richburg. Number four, Blake Whipple. Number five, Curtis Marino. Number six, Mike Reese. Number seven, Samuel Edison. Number eight, Dexter Davis. Number 10, Jonathan Gray. Number 11, Mike West. Number 12, Keith West. Number 14, Freddie Bird. Number 15, Tripp Thompson. Number 16, Wayne McDowell. Number 18, Derek Mickey. Number 19, James Richardson. Number 20, Jenner Price. Number 21, Mike Singletary. Number 23, Trent Player. Number 24, Rodney Jordan. Number 25, Billy Gibson. 33, Jimmy Noonan. 34, Isaac Pringle. 35, Bobby Brown. Number 36, Broderick Williams. 37, Stacy Kuhn. 40, Buddy Noonan. 41, Stacy Shaw. 43, Dean Richburg. 44, Scott Siggers. 45, Mark Burton. 46, Melvin Bennett. 48, Rhett Buckley. 51, Kelvin McFadden. 52, Mike Schichter. 53, Leverett Owens. 55, Elliot Major. 56, Mark Van Es. 60, Gary Hurlaw. 61, Ernest Gass. 62, Alonzo Washington. 63, Steve Duggan. Number 64, Fly Hudson. 66, Jay Bauman. 70, Billy Goen. 71, Jerry Paul. 74, Robert Andrews. Number 76, John Holliday. 77, John Pettinger. 78, Glenn Broom. Number 80, Donnie Perlaw. Number 81, Robert Cochran. 82, Hal Starr. 84, Haley Palmer. 89, Joe Brown. Number 90, Tony Hainsworth. 91, Harry McRae. At number 92, Frank Taylor. Class 4A, Division I, Lower State Champions, the Sumter High Gamecocks. Presentation of medallions to the state champion, Gaffney High School, Indiana. assistant principal Bill Cleveland and school board chairman Joe Paris. Again, numerically, number 10, Dan Queen. Number 11, Louis Casciano. Number 12, John Burgess. 13, Eric Swofford. Number 14, Wesley Tate. 15, John Westbrook. Number 20, Corey Leach. 21, David Sellers. 22, Michael Bridges. 23, Mike Gibson. 24, Reggie Williams. Number 30, Steve Palmer. 31, Cornel Hobson. 32, John Berry. 33, Robert Hardy. 34, John Third. 40, Mike Wallace. 42, Tyrone Phillips. Number 50, Kenneth Quisnet. 51, Philip Ross. 52, William Palmer. 53, Ryan Dawkins. 54, Scott Gibson. 55, Ryan Hartzell. 56, Sonny DeLashman. 60, Mike Harris. 61, Danny Martin. 62, John Ewing. Number 63, Ryan Talon. 64, Billy Richards. 65, Bruce Button. 67, Brian Bassey. 69, Patrick Horan. 72, Scott Miner. Number 73, Mark Chandler. Number 74, Jeff Gordon. 76, Ryan Thorne. Number 77, Dean Gaffney. 78, Roger Myers. 79, Travis Bonner. Number 80, Russell Smith. Number 81, Billy Barrett. Number 82, Lamont Manning. Number 83, Benji Siegel. 84, Ryan Phillips. 85, Clay Stacy. Number 90, Glenn McElroy. Number 91, Bubba Smith. 92, Kevin Hemet. 93, Eric Cash. 94, Steve Corey. Number 95, Trent Hartman. Ladies and gentlemen, completing the season with a record of 10-4, state champions, Class 4A, Division I, the Indians of Gaffney High School, presenting the 4A championship trophy presentations of the 4A committee. First of the runners-up, presentation will be made by Mr. W.D. Hutz and High School League Executive Director Jeff Pinkerton. At the completion of that, the championship trophy presented to Gaffney by Mr. Hutz and Mr. Pinkerton. Again, ladies and gentlemen, fans of both schools and fans of excellent sportsmanship on high school athletics, thank you for being with us. Congratulations to both teams for their seasons, and we hope to see you next year.
Championship game, the Gaffney Indians defeating Sumter for Gaffney's first state championship, of course, since the late 60s. Robert Hardy certainly paid dividends for the Gaffney Indians early in this ball game. Second play of the evening, and Robert took off untouched. All of a sudden, the Indians had staked their claim to the state championship. And from that point on, Gaffney really would not let Sumter loose. Senior defensive back Reggie Williams coming up with the interception. That led to another Gaffney drive. It was capped by Mr. Hardy, who scored his second touchdown of the night on that fourth down run. It was 34-7 Gaffney at halftime. Sumter, though, has been a comeback club all season, and Sumter was at it again, scoring twice within 5 minutes of the third period to draw within 14 points at 34-20. And then the defense really took over. Trey Stacy with the timely interception. Good move by Trey to get in front of the receiver. That set the stage for the final score of the night. Number 40, Ike Wallace, coming right at you with a second touchdown scamper, and Gaffney had its state championship win.
We knew what we was looking for, and all we had to do was execute. And that's what we did. And number one, 85 state champions, baby! Woo!
We had faith. We had faith in ourselves. We worked hard, we worked up to this moment. And that's where we at now, the state champion.
How does it
feel? It feels great.
And it's been a hard year, and these kids have really worked hard for this. I can say I'm proud of all of them.
And the entire town of Gaffney very proud of its Indians as well, as they win the state championship defeating Sumter last night. And our congratulations to them as well. Also to Mid-Carolina.
Time. The championships that were won at Clinton and at Gaffney when we take a look at sports next. Stay with us. In the 3A. Now, Saturday night, the Upstate turned the trick once again when Gaffney High School and A.L. Curtis's club broke the jinx that has been haunting them at Williams-Brice Stadium. Twice before, they went into Williams-Brice with good football teams capable of winning the Big 16 title, only to fall a little bit short. Well, they took no chances on that this past Saturday. Robert Hardy with a long, long touchdown run, and that helped out. Rick Thompson with an interception, and then more good, hard defense and good, solid running. And Gaffney went on to take a walloping big win over Sumter. And with it, the obvious reaction. Everybody feels great to break the jinx and bring the Big 16 title home to the Upstate, and Gaffney in particular.
It feels great. And it's been a hard year, and these kids have really worked hard for this. I can say I'm proud of all of them.
We had faith. We had faith in ourselves. We worked hard. We worked up to this moment. And that's what we at now, the state champion.
I can watch that young man smile all day. That's what high school football is all about, folks. You hear people say that all the time, but that is it right there. Young fellows pulling together to accomplish something, and our hats off to them. Also to mid
team with the haircuts, right, Stan?
They were the ones. I guess maybe that's why they got the hats, to stay warm in the cold weather now, but that is a nice-looking hat, and I am most appreciative of that from the students and faculty at Gaffney High School.
Looks better than the haircuts, anyway.